Liz is here from the Convention and Visitors Bureau. Go Rockford.com. How are you?
Good.
Yeah, I'm not happy with the forecast, but maybe it'll be spotty and not get in our way.
I know. Well, it's done that before. It's been
looks like City Market
terrible.
Could be a very good plus tonight. It could come later.
Yeah, it always looks terrible, and then it usually, hopefully, cross your fingers, turns out to be fine.
Because I know, as always, you've got a sheet in front of you full of stuff for people to do. I'm betting some of it's outside.
Yeah,
the lion's share of it is outside.
A little bit.
All right, what are we looking at this weekend?
Well, we have a lot going on downtown, actually. So it's the first day of summer.
Yes.
And so we're celebrating downtown.
2 hours from now, by the way, 10:54 this morning, it becomes summer.
Oh, so we're still in spring.
You and I are in the last 2 hours of spring.
Oh, my God. Well, the rain better get its fill in now.
Do it now and then become summer-like.
In 2 hours.
Perfect. So we're celebrating the first day of summer.
Yes. And so you can go downtown. It's actually starting today. So while you're downtown at City Market, you can also shop the blocks.
Cool.
And that's actually starting at 10 a.m., so right at the beginning of summer. And it goes to 9 p.m., and it's today and tomorrow. So Shop the Blocks is put on by the River District Association. And so that's going to be shopping, going to restaurants, all the local businesses downtown. A lot of them have awesome specials and deals. So this is a great way to spend your weekend. Plus, they have some fun activities. They have their little parklets set out with
fun
activities.
The parklets are the coolest thing.
They really are. I mean, I saw one year that was like, I mean, it's literally the size of a parking space.
Right.
But it was like mini golf. A little mini golf hole. It's
Come on by. Yeah, we just set up a little parklet. That's what they call it. And
they're really fun. Exactly.
And the cool thing, Shop the Blocks, if I have this right, it's the last full weekend of June, July, and August.
Yep, so this is the June weekend. So stay tuned for the July and August weekends when you can shop the blocks some more.
It's really cool. It's a great area to get down. Really nice people. Really cool deals. You'll like this.
Oh, yeah. It's so fun. And then while you're downtown shopping for Shop the Blocks on Saturday, you can also bike around downtown because it's the River District 12.
Oh, nice.
And it's called the River District 12 because it's held for 12 hours. So it's 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Now, you don't have to bike that whole time.
No, it's basically what you want to do.
You'll be tired if you do that.
Or you're in marvelous shape.
Exactly. Well, it's a 4.5 mile loop. And so it's not quite 12 miles, but you can bike 12 miles if you want because you can bike the loop as many times as you want. So you have this little passport that you can get stamped at certain checkpoints, and your goal is to rack up the most miles throughout the day. So it's fun because you get to be on your bike and you get to see downtown from a bicycle point of view rather than just breezing through in your car.
Right.
So it's so fun. And while you're down there, you know, you can take your time. You can stop into restaurants, stop into the shops, participate in Shop the Blocks.
Oh, yeah. You're not timed or anything along those lines.
No.
It just goes from, what, 7 to 7, like you were saying?
Yes.
The more little punches you get, the more little passports you get, the more little perks might be involved in this as well.
Right. So, you know, it's a great weekend to be downtown, which leads us to our next event.
Downtown?
Also downtown. So City Market is tonight,
right?
But they have their Vintage Market, the Rockford Vintage Market, is on Saturday. And so that's from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. And so that's at the City Market Pavilion. So it's not quite the same vendors as Rockford City Market because these are the vendors that sell vintage goods, antiques, repurposed items. So if that is right up your alley, this is the place to be. It's free to attend. Of course, it will cost you if you want to buy something.
Yeah, they probably won't just hand it over on your way, citizen.
Not a bunch of freebies. But you can go and browse for free. It's going to be a lot of fun. Plus, they have some food there. So if you get hungry, shopping and biking, you're bound to get hungry.
You're burning some calories while you're down there.
You
better replenish. We don't want anybody just dragging themselves down the sidewalk.
Right.
And vintage has never been hotter than it is right now either.
Oh my gosh, it's so popular right now.
And every sort of style, everything you're looking for, from music to vintage equipment to clothing to you name it, we've got some wonderful purveyors of vintage stuff here in town.
Oh yeah, everybody is not so into the cookie cutter, especially furniture and decorations and stuff for your home. Vintage repurposed goods are in right now.
And for those of a certain age, and I include myself in that demographic, the cool thing about going to a vintage store, it may be cool, maybe not, is when you go in, you'll see things that were in your house when you were a kid that are now have a price tag on them that you're, wait, what? What? I remember my mom throwing that out.
I know.
We had a kitchen table when I was a kid that I have seen in more vintage stores that right now it's 10 times what my parents paid for it. And my mother couldn't wait to get rid of it.
Oh, my God.
But now it fits that profile of being cool, vintage, early 1960s kind of thing. And people, if we still had it, it would be very, very valuable. But her happiest day was shoving that to the curb.
Oh, my gosh.
So you go through these vintage shops. If you're a certain age, you go, why didn't we keep
that?
Wait
a minute.
Why didn't we keep that? We could have kept that. My house could have filled this store.
I know. And it's so weird because it's such a flashback, too. You're like, wait a minute, I know that.
It's also an indicator of when you're aging a little bit, when you get a little annoyed that something is looked at as being vintage.
Yes.
Wait a minute, vintage? That's younger than I am.
I know. I do that.
You have
like,
many years to go before you start to get these feelings.
It started. I mean, they have stuff in museums like at the Smithsonian in D.C. where it's like, oh, look at this old item. I'm like, that is a phone that I had.
That sat on the
teenager.
Table at home. That was our home phone.
What?
Don't put it next to Alexander Graham Bell.
What do you mean? It's an antique.
See, this is why you want to hit this vintage sale. You'll thoroughly enjoy that.
Never
that's Saturday,
know what
right?
You're going to find. Yes.
Never know. All right. Have we missed anything?
Well, if we missed anything and you want to learn more about the events that we talked about today, you can head over to GoRockford.com. We have a ton of events listed on our calendar.
And you guys continue to distinguish yourself with great events and cool things to get together for Fred Van Vliet and all the other things that the RACVB has their fingers into. Really, that's what makes it fun downtown.
Yes.
So, well done to everybody. GoRockford.com. Have a great weekend.
Thanks, you too.